Alex, how did you first get involved in motor racing?
In my early teens, I used to be taken to various race meetings around the country by a local Brighton Formula Ford 2000 team. That rather initiated my enthusiasm with motorsport, and as one does, this led to the scouring of weekly pages of Autosport, which is an essential piece of literature for any enthusiast and participant, indeed. I knew Jonathan Palmer. He used to take me around to a lot of his races. He was racing Formula 3 at the time. And his encouragement and suggestions have really helped me a very great deal. So last year I did the Jim Russell Racing Drivers course at Snetterton, which gave me my first race experience. So this year we've been contesting the Formula 1st Championship, which is like an initial stepping stone for all young drivers.
The Bremer Grant team consists of how many people?
It consists of two drivers, myself and David Grant. Over and above that, we're managed by Cortex Systems Marketing under Ian Patterson. We're run by GAH Racing, which is a Letchworth-based team, comprising of roughly three mechanics per driver on any given race day.
How many cars does your team have?
We run two cars in the team. They're managed, as I say, by about six mechanics, three apiece. At the moment, as I say, we're running Formula 1st, but we're in the process of testing Formula Ford 2000s, getting the feel of them for next year. They're much bigger and faster cars.
With your ultimate aim being Formula 1?
That's right, as soon as possible, really. I mean, this is a step in the right direction. They're winged and slicked cars, that is to say that they have the same bodywork and aerodynamic configuration as a Formula 1 car, and the same disciplines are required in terms of knowing what tyres to run where and how to look after them. It's a very important aspect of single-seater motor racing.
You're a full-time racing driver now.
Yeah, that's right. It's the organisation involved is required that we turn full-time. It's a full-time occupation in terms of testing, working for our sponsors and looking for new sponsors for next year.
How do your sponsors benefit?
Well, through our management organisation, we can provide sponsors with a comprehensive advertising package in the same way as television or billboard advertising can. Over and above the fact we're 145 mile an hour billboards, motor racing is a sports entertainment industry. It comprises of a large number of different aspects. Sponsors' involvement can be limitless.
To the drivers, to getting the cars here, and ensuring all aspects of finance are covered. But more importantly, my job is to support the sponsors and ensure they're getting what they want out of the service that we provide.
Do you have any other business interests?
Yes, I do. I run a software house that serves the commodity industry in the city, and I must say, I find this a welcome challenge and an alternative.
Do you think management's necessary?
Yes, I think it's mandatory for success. There's a lot of drivers that have a lot of talent, but what you need is to couple that talent with sound and management guidance, and also the backing from the mechanics.
Is sponsorship difficult?
No, it needn't be. We offer our sponsors a very comprehensive package that they can take advantage of depending on what they want.
What do the sponsors get out of it?
It depends what they tell us they want, and we'll try and address that. For instance, a company may want to involve its staff, in which case we can invite them along for a day in the pits and a day with the team. Or alternatively, it may be they want the name of the company put out to the general public. Now remember, there's a very large crowd for, say, Formula One, and these cars will race on the same day to those very same crowds. So for a fraction of that cost, you can get your name out there.
So, in other words, you're running a very professional team.
That's what we put together, and that's what we'll be putting through into 87 and 88.